हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू डीएडए में। होप आप सभी का प्रिपरेशन बहुत अच्छा से चल रहा है। तो इस प्रीलिम्स रिवीजन सीरीज़ में हम कवर कर रहे हैं हमारे साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी के लास्ट वन एंड हाफ ईयर करंट अफेयर्स। तो एज यू नो, प्रीलिम्स के लिए लास्ट वन ईयर का करंट अफेयर्स नॉट सफिशिएंट। इट्स इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर अस टू गो अ बिट बैक एंड गेट टू नो द करंट अफेयर्स विच हैपेंड इवन कपल ऑफ ईयर्स बैक ऑल्सो। तो इसके लिए हमारे लिए स्टैटिक भी बहुत ज़रूरी है। वी शुड बी एबल टू रिलेट द करंट एस्पेक्ट्स विद अलॉन्ग विद द स्टैटिक पार्ट्स ऑफ द सिलेबस। तो इसके लिए हम इस साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी करंट अफेयर्स रिवीजन सीरीज में दोनों स्टैटिक और करंट अफेयर्स के तालमेल के साथ कवर कर रहे हैं, सो दैट यू विल हैव बेटर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स। ओके, सो अब हम कंटिन्यू करते हैं हमारे रिवीजन सीरीज के साथ। दिस इज़ पार्ट 21 ऑफ द वीडियो, पार्ट 21 ऑफ द लेक्चर। इनफैक्ट होप यू हैव सीन ऑल द अदर 20 पार्ट्स। दिस इज पार्ट 21। तो इस लेक्चर में हम डिजीज़ हेल्थ एंड मेडिसिन के बारे में कवर करते हैं। तो इस लेक्चर में वी विल कवर द ई सिगरेट्स, सेप्सिस, व्हाट इज सेप्सिस, विल कवर दैट। आफ्टर दैट वी विल टॉक अबाउट द फिक्स डोज कॉम्बिनेशंस, विल टॉक अबाउट एंथ्रैक्स वैक्सीन्स, द ब्रुसेलोसिस कंट्रोल प्रोग्राम, प्रोटॉन थेरेपी, एंड देन फाइनली वी विल टॉक अबाउट द नीफा वायरस ऑल्सो। वी विल टॉक अबाउट ऑल ऑफ दिस थिंग्स इन दिस लेक्चर। तो चलिए शुरू करते हैं। फर्स्ट, ई सिगरेट्स। क्या है ई सिगरेट्स? तो ई सिगरेट्स आर द अल्टरनेटिव टू द सिगरेट्स दैट आर अवेलेबल। ओके, दीज आर ई सिगरेट्स बिकॉज दे आर बर्नड, यू नो, द लिक्विड इन द सिगरेट इज बर्नड इलेक्ट्रॉनिकली। सो इन अ फिजिकल सिगरेट इट्स मेड अप ऑफ द टोबैको एंड ऑल, बट दिस ई सिगरेट इट हैज अ केमिकल इन इट एंड द केमिकल इज बर्नड इलेक्ट्रॉनिकली यूजिंग बैटरीज। सो देन द फ्लेवर विल बी इन्फ्यूज्ड बाय द पीपल। सो दिस इंडियन काउंसिल ऑफ मेडिकल रिसर्च ICMR हैज रिकमेंडेड ए complete ban on the electronic nicotine delivery systems including e-cigarettes. It has completely banned this e-cigarettes. Why it was banned? It was banned because in order to avoid the harmful effects of this e-cigarettes. The e-cigarettes are addictive, harmful, and has harmful ingredients like flavoring agents and vaporizers. So vaporizers means they will vaporize after receiving certain amount of energy. So they have adverse impacts including the DNA damage, neurological disorders, carcinogenic toxicity, etc. These are the disadvantages of the e-cigarettes. So because of these disadvantages, the e-cigarettes has been banned, or you can say they are recommended by the ICMR to be banned. So why? Generally, the tobacco and everything in India is governed by the Cigarettes and Other Tobacco Products Prohibition of Advertisements Regulation, Trade and Commerce, Production, Supply and Distribution Act of 2003, COTPA Act it is called. But the e-cigarettes, it do not fall under the purview of this COTPA Act. So, easily, iske liye separately we have to bring in a law or we have to bring in a regulation because they are not governed by this originally existing COTPA Act. Okay, that is about the e-cigarettes. Next one, sepsis. So, what is sepsis? Sepsis is a life-threatening organ dysfunction caused by body's immune system overreacting in response to an infection. So, generally what happens when your body gets infected, the immune system responds to that. The immune system, in fact, it will send an anti-agent. So, if there is any virus or fungi in our body, so what our immune system will do is, immune system will go against it. It will send an anti-agent against that agent. Okay. So, generally, in this problem of sepsis, what will happen is that the immune system will overreact for a small thing. So, when it overreacts, what will happen is it will cause damage to the body. So, sepsis is a life-threatening organ dysfunction caused by body's immune system overreacting in response to an infection. So, for an infection, the immune system will over-respond. So, when it over-responds, that affects the body. In fact, it affects the own body. Okay, because of the over-response. So this overactive toxic response can lead to tissue damage, multi-organ failures and death. So when the immune system overly responds, it will damage the tissues or different organs. So because of that, multiple organ failure happens and finally it will lead to the death of the patient. So generally sepsis can be triggered by a variety of pathogens like viruses, bacteria, fungi and parasites. So when these infect the body, you know, this sepsis can come into picture. It can be triggered by these organisms. Okay, that is about sepsis. So sepsis is a overreaction of the immune system. Next one, fixed dose combinations. What are these fixed dose combinations? So generally, when you take medicine for any disease, for any, like, let's say fever or anything, when you take medicine, they will give you in combinations. So let's say when you have a fever, the doctor will tell you to take two type of tablets. That means it's a combination. So recently, the Drug Advisory Body Subcommittee has asked pharmaceutical companies to prove that 324 combination medicines are safe and effective. Okay, so the advisory committee, it has ordered the pharmaceutical companies to prove that these 324 combination of medicines are safe and effective for all the patients of all categories, and decide which drug should continue to be sold and which drug should be banned in India, because every drug cannot be sold in India. They might be harmful for the people also. Okay, so these fixed dose combinations are a combination of two or more active drug ingredients in a fixed ratios of doses. So whenever you take any dose of any medicine for any disease, you will be taking it in a specific ratio. It cannot be taken as it is. So for that, the fixed dose combination is useful. Okay, that is about the FDC. Next, anthrax. So anthrax scare at Assam Pobitora sanctuary after the death of two Asiatic wild buffaloes. So first, remember the Pobitora sanctuary. The Pobitora sanctuary is in Assam. Pobitora sanctuary is in Assam, and it has Asiatic wild buffaloes. So here you can see in this picture, this is the Asiatic wild buffalo. Okay, so it is this disease, this anthrax, this has killed several buffaloes in the Pobitora sanctuary. This disease is caused by Bacillus anthracis, a germ that lives in the soil. A germ that lives in the soil killed these buffaloes. So not only buffaloes, a lot of animals will get infected with this kind of a disease. So isliye this was in news, isliye news mein hai. So animals such as cattle, sheep, goats, and more often than people, they get infected. People can get anthrax from contact with infected animals, wool, meat, or hides. It is spread by spores. Okay, so anthrax is a disease caused by Bacillus anthracis, a germ that lives in the soil. Okay, that is about anthrax. Next, for this anthrax, a vaccine has been found out by the DRDO and JNU scientists. They have worked in collaboration. They found out a vaccine for this anthrax. So a new vaccine claimed to be superior than the this new vaccine is claimed to be superior than the existing ones, as it can generate immune response to anthrotoxin as well as the spores. So it will generate a response to the anthrotoxin as well as the spores. This is about anthravaccine developed by DRDO and JNU scientists. Next, the brucellosis control program. What is the brucellosis control program? It envisages 100% vaccination coverage of female cattle and buffalo calves that are 4 to 8 months of age once in a lifetime. Okay, so this brucellosis control program envisages 100% vaccination coverage. Okay, that is the program. It is for vaccination of the calves and the cattle once in a lifetime. Next one, proton therapy. The proton therapy, also known as proton beam therapy, it is also known as proton beam therapy. It is a type of radiation therapy. It uses protons rather than X-rays to treat cancer. Normally, you know, on the chemotherapy and all, it uses X-rays to treat the cancer, but it's in proton therapy. The proton beam therapy, the protons are used for the treatment. Protons are used for the treatment. This is about the proton therapy. Next one, Nipah virus. So recently Nipah virus was in news, but the Nipah virus is not new to us. It's an old virus. First, it was discovered in 1998-99 in Malaysia and Singapore, and it's a zoonotic disease. Zoonotic disease means it occurs in animals. Okay, it's a zoonotic disease. So this disease spreads from animals to humans. It first appeared in the domestic pigs and has been found among several species of domestic animals, including dogs, cats, goats, horses, and sheep. Okay, the organism causing Nipah virus is elephantiasis. It is an RNA or ribonucleic acid virus. It's a RNA virus. It's a Nipah virus. Elephantiasis. It is encephalitis. It's an RNA virus. Encephalitis is an RNA virus which causes the Nipah virus disease. Okay. Now let's revise what we have studied. So first we have seen about e-cigarettes. You know, the ICMR has recommended for the ban of these e-cigarettes. We have seen that. After that, we have seen this problem, sepsis. Sepsis is a life-threatening disease where it's a life-threatening problem where the immune system overreacts to a small problem. It overreacts to a certain pathogen like virus or bacteria which has come into the body. The immune system will overreact for that, and this will cause damage to the body. It will damage the tissues, and finally, it can lead to multiple organ failure, which leads to the death of a person. And after that, fixed dose combinations. We have seen the fixed dose combinations. हमने देखा कि हमारी you know subcommittee on the drugs, they have asked the drug various drug pharmaceuticals to approve the fixed dose combinations so that they are not harmful for the patients. After that, we seen about anthrax. Anthrax is that disease caused by the Bacillus anthracis. Okay, so this is caused by this Bacillus anthracis which lives in the soil. It has killed Asiatic wild buffaloes in Assam. So anthrax vaccine has been found out by the DRDO and JNU scientists. After that, we have seen the brucellosis control program. It is to control the brucellosis among the cattle and the calves. Okay, it's a once in a lifetime program for them. Next, we have seen the proton therapy, wherein which proton is being used for treating cancer patients. Earlier, we used to use X-rays. Now we are using protons. Next, we have seen Nipah virus. Nipah virus originated in 1998-99, and here we can see the organism that causes Nipah virus is encephalitis, which is an RNA or ribonucleic acid virus. Okay, so that's it, friends, in this lecture. I'll see you again in the next lecture. Till then, keep studying and stay tuned. Jai Hind.